everyone. Well, today we're going to talk about hand pollination. I posted a few pictures on Instagram, I think it was a couple of weeks ago, and we had a great discussion over there. So if you're not following me over there on Instagram, you want to go check out CaliKim29 over on Instagram and join in the conversation. So we're going to talk about what it is, why you do it, and how you do it. So first of all, let's just start with what it is. Hand pollination is basically pollinating your plants manually to get more production. Maybe you don't see a lot of bees around, maybe your plant's just not producing how it should. So this is a great way to kind of give it a boost and hopefully get some more production out of whatever plant it is that you want to pollinate. So let me just show you what plant I'm going to work on today. Well, today I'm going to be hand pollinating my bush zucchini plant right here, and I really wanted some production out of it because it's a nice, small, compact variety of zucchini. So far, I haven't gotten anything out of it yet this season, and I've been looking for two things in order to start hand pollinating this plant: a male flower and a female flower. Now, a lot of people ask, what's the difference between a male flower and a female flower? Well, let me show you. Okay, so let me just show you the difference here between the male and female flower. And this plant has both, so it's a perfect time to start hand pollinating. The male flower is just a flower with a stem attached, and I'll move this back a little bit so you can see. There's no fruit or anything underneath, it's just the stem. And then on the other side of the plant is the female flower. And you can see there's the flower there with the fruit attached, and that's the difference. The female flower has a little teeny tiny baby fruit attached to it. So I want this fruit to develop and grow into a full-sized zucchini. So that's where the pollination comes in. I'm going to show you how to do it in two different ways. First, we're going to use a little paintbrush, and then we're going to use just the flower. So let me show you with the paintbrush first. Normally, you would do this in the morning, early in the morning. Now, we're out here in the afternoon, so in the morning, normally this flower is open, but because it's not open right now, I'm going to peel it back with my hands very gently, and that's where you find the pollen, is right inside the flower. So basically, I'm doing the work of the bees. A lot of you know that there's been a big decline in the bee population, and so a few of my plants have needed hand pollinating this summer in order to develop fruit. So right inside, might be hard for you guys to see, but you can see the pollen down in there. Okay, so I'm just going to put my paintbrush down in there and get some of the pollen on it. This is really pretty simple to do. It sounds like such an intimidating garden task, but it's really not.
Well, that's still.
We've got a little bit of pollen there on the end of the paintbrush. You can see the little yellow bits of pollen. Okay, now I'm going to go over to the female flower, being really careful with my paintbrush not to knock the pollen off. I'm going to peel the flower apart here really carefully. And we're just going to put the pollen dip the paintbrush and just kind of dab it around the center of the flower. There we go. Hopefully giving that fruit a chance to pollinate and then really take off. In a couple of days, if this works, we should see this fruit begin to grow. So let me just show you the second way to do it. Okay, the second way to hand pollinate is super easy as well. You don't need a paintbrush. You just need to take off the male flower. So I'm just going to go ahead and pick it off here. And you just open it up. So you can see all the good pollen and everything inside. Okay, and this method works really well on plants like melons and things like that where the flowers are really small, but it'll work on this too. So you simply take it, and then I'm gonna peel open the female flower here. And it's okay if you're kind of peeling it open, it's not gonna ruin things, or if you rip part of the petals or anything like that. And I'm just simply going to take my male flower and kind of put it right in there on top of the female, dab it around, get some of that pollen in there, and pull it out and kind of close that flower back up. And there you go. It's super easy, really quick to do. And again, you want to try and come out in the morning and do it when the flowers are open. It'll be a whole lot easier. And then watch that fruit there for growth over the next couple of days. And hopefully you'll start to develop more female flowers and more male flowers. So you can keep doing this process with plants all over your garden. So I hope you found this little tip helpful. And you know what? Let me go show you the one I was talking about on Instagram. You guys think you'd want to see that? Come on, let's go. Okay, this butternut squash plant is so incredible. It's actually climbing up my trellis now, and it's just spreading out all behind me. It's looking a little wilted in the afternoon sun, but let me just show you one I hand pollinated a couple of weeks ago. The flower I showed on Instagram was over by the trellis a little ways. I did the same thing. I just took my paintbrush, put it in the middle of the male flower, and came down over here where there's a teeny tiny, at the time, baby fruit, baby butternut, and let me show you what it looks like now. I want to say this is 2, maybe 3 weeks ago. This is so cool. Hope you guys can see this. I don't want to break the stem, so I'm just going to barely lift it up. Let me move this leaves out of the way. Look at this, guys. Isn't this exciting? I love butternut squash, and this plant is actually going crazy, and I'm trying to help it along however I can. So this is what hand pollinating can do for you. Give you better production, just kind of helps the bees along a little bit, and just give you fruit wherever you're not seeing fruit in your garden. So look for those male and female flowers, and as soon as you see those, get your paintbrushes out, get your little male flowers out, pollinate those females, and look for some good production in your garden. Let me know if you tried hand pollinating, what kind of results you've gotten, maybe some tips if you have any, pop them in the comments section below. Oh, and camera guy, would you mind getting a shot of that sunflower behind me? I love this flower, guys. It's so pretty. It's just starting to bloom, really brightens up my day whenever I see it. My favorite flower in the garden. We'll see you guys on the next video.